Sodium charged with carbonate 3 Na2CO3 reacting with hydrogen chloride HCl to give sodium chloride NaCl plus H2O as water and carbon dioxide CO2. Using this equation, what volume of carbon dioxide measured at s.t.p is liberated when 53 grams of sodium carbonate is dissolved in hydrochloric acid, given that 1 mole of gas occupies 22.4 dm cube at s.t.p. Atomic mass of sodium is given to be 23, carbon 12 and oxygen 16. Solution. Before we proceed, if you are yet to subscribe to this channel, kindly do that and as well click on the notification bell so as to be notified as soon as new videos have been released. You can also join our Telegram channel via the link in the description box, which is also being displayed on the screen right now. Let's continue. We have been given a chemical equation in the question above, so let's rewrite the chemical equation first. We have Na2CO3 plus HCl. We have 2 moles here to give 2 moles of NaCl plus H2O plus CO2. So looking at this equation, we discover it is a balanced chemical equation. We have 2 atoms of sodium, 2 present here for carbon 1. Here also 1, oxygen 3, summing this we have 1 plus, so that's 3 in the previous side. The other side for hydrogen is 2, and previous side is 2 as well, for chlorine 2, and here also 2. So this is the balanced chemical equation. Now after writing the balanced chemical equation, the next thing we are to determine is the compound in which we want to work with, which will consist of the unknown from the question and the one in which we have been given information about. So according to the question here, we have been made to know that we have 53 grams of sodium carbonate. So we have sodium carbonate. Why the unknown we are working with is the carbon dioxide. That is, we want to determine the volume of carbon dioxide that will be produced at the end of this reaction. So here now we'll just be considering sodium carbonate and carbon dioxide. So for sodium carbonate, we are being given the mass that was dissolved, but according to this chemical equation, we have to determine the reacting mass itself to make the solution easier. So to determine the reacting mass, just like as the formula for mass that says number of moles multiplied by molar mass, here the number of moles is gotten as the coefficient from the equation why the molar mass will be calculated, and that's what we'll be doing now. So molar mass of sodium carbonate which is Na2CO3 equals, so we'll be adding the atomic masses of each of the elements present in the compound. So for sodium we have 2 atoms present here. I'll say 2 multiplied by the atomic mass of sodium itself is 23 multiplied by 23 plus, for carbon just 1, so and the atomic mass of carbon is 12, so plus 12 plus, for oxygen we have 3 atoms, so 3 multiplied by the atomic mass which is 16. Calculating this we have 46 plus 12 plus 48. Adding this together we have 106 and the units grams per mole. Now we've determined the molar mass of sodium carbonate. The next thing is to calculate the reacting mass. So you say reacting mass of sodium carbonate. As earlier said, that reacting mass will then be the number of moles from the equation. Do not forget the number of moles according to the equation, that is, which is the coefficient of the compound we are dealing with in the equation, multiplied by the molar mass of the compound. So here now for sodium carbonate, the coefficient here is 1. So here I'll just say 1 multiplied by the molar mass, which is 106, and this gives 106 grams. So this is just a first part to the question. Now we've gotten the reacting mass of sodium carbonate, but I've been made to understand that 53 grams was dissolved. 106 grams should liberate 1 mole of carbon dioxide. 1 mole, because the coefficient of carbon dioxide here is just 1. That's where I got the mole, the number of moles I'm stating from. So 106 grams should liberate 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Then what if we are being given 53 grams? How many moles will be liberated? The moles will be liberated, we do not know, and we do not know the volume as well. And to solve this, just as we have been asked in the question, to calculate the volume of carbon dioxide produced, we can do it in two ways. We can use the formula method and we can use the relationship method, that is, we'll be comparing. In this case here, I'll be using the relationship method. Using the formula method, we'll be saying moles equals to volume over amount at s.t.p. That means we'll have to calculate the number of moles first. But if I'll be using the relationship method, I'll be skipping the process of calculating the number of moles. I'll just be equating the values I have. So from here, we are being made to know that 1 mole of gas occupies 22.4 dm cube at s.t.p. If I have 1 mole of carbon dioxide produced, virtually I can say 22.4 dm cube of carbon dioxide is produced. I'll come again. 1 mole of carbon dioxide is produced according to this equation. So since 1 mole of a gas occupies 22.4 dm cube, then I can say that 22.4 dm cube of carbon dioxide is being produced. Let's continue. So yeah, let's note that. One mole of gas occupies 22.4 dm cube at s.t.p. Then 106 grams, according to the equation now. So 106 grams of sodium carbonate liberated based on the equation, 1 mole. So instead of saying 1 mole of carbon dioxide, now I'm using the relationship method, don't forget, and I will just say 22.4 dm cube liberated, 22.4 dm cube of carbon dioxide. Now from the question, we are given 53 grams of sodium carbonate is being used. Then I will say 53 grams of sodium carbonate will then yield, or will liberate, x dm cube of carbon dioxide CO2. I want to believe that the relationship written here is well understood. This arrow here signifies the liberation, or we can see what is being produced. Let's continue. So we want to solve for x. So to get x, we'll be cross multiplying indirectly. So we assume we have an equal sign here. So yeah, this and this will work together. This and this will work together. So yeah, x will then be equal to 53 grams multiplied by 22.4 dm cube divided by 106 grams. So calculating this, for the numerator I have 1187.2 divided by the denominator, which is still 106 dm cube, which equals 11.2 dm cube, and this will be serving as the final answer. We can see that volume of carbon dioxide, that is CO2, liberated is 11.2 m cubed. So we've come to the end of the solution to the question. Do not forget to subscribe and as well click on the notification bell so as to be notified as soon as new videos are being released. There's also a link to our Telegram channel in the description box. You can join our channel via the link for better communication and as well leave your comments in the comment section below. Thank you.